Hi everyone, I'm back with another video. In this video, I'm gonna be showing you what I packed for my Cosmetology State Board Practical exam. Of course, I went based off the PSI package. You can get it online on their website. Basically, this is the outline of the whole exam. It shows you all the supplies that you're gonna need, what needs to be labeled, what doesn't. Also, from start to finish, it shows you each service you're gonna do and how long you have for each service. So I'm gonna show you how I packed my kit. Of course, everybody's gonna pack their kit differently. This is how I did it. So, of course, I have all of my bags right here from start to finish. It was so satisfying packing for this exam. I don't know why. I just like doing stuff like this. And I am just gonna go over each bag, what's in each bag. And here is my mannequin in the back on her stand. So a lot of the things, I did order them off of Amazon. It's easier for me, just a few clicks, you order the stuff and it's right at your door in a few days. I did get some last minute things from the supply store nearby, which for me is Sally's. So it did take me quite a while to pack this kit just because I was procrastinating and pushing it back. Finally, I got it done. Now I'm gonna take my exam at the end of this month. Hopefully I pass it, or I will pass it. If I don't, well, I'll just take it again. Little backstory to why I'm packing my kit. Of course, most of the time when you're in cosmetology class, you'll take the exam right after your school will help you pack your kit, and you already have like kind of like a kit because they give it to you at the beginning of the class. And you have most of the things, and at the end, when you complete your hours, they just help you like pack for your state board. What most schools do. I actually took dual credit in high school, and I got my hours, completed everything, and I had actually booked my lecture exam, and I ended up not going and like doing like a whole 360 career change. So I ended up going to college to try to pursue a nursing career, but it didn't work out. So now I'm back here 7 years later taking my cosmetology exams so I can get licensed. It's been 7 years, so I called the TDLR to see if they can, if I had to like take any like hours to kind of refresh my memory so I can go take my lecture exam, or if there's like anything I have to do to kind of, I guess, activate my hours since it's been that long, 7 years since I took those hours. They told me they could just activate my hours and I can go ahead and go take the exam. So I studied really hard. I got the cosmetology book and I did watch a few videos on YouTube so I can practice for my lecture exam. I took it, I passed it with an 85. So not bad for 7 years later. And now I am finally finished packing my practical exam kit for state board. And I'm gonna show you how I packed it. I'm a visual person, so I like to see like how people do things. And that's how I learn. Especially with this, because it's been 7 years since I've been in cosmetology. So I wasn't really sure what to pack. Like I said, I went based off the PSI package. I literally got all of the supply that's listed there. I labeled it. And then I basically just went over each service and separated the things to each bag. So each bag is a service. So let's get started. I'm going to show you what's in each of these bags. I'm going to show you my mannequin right here. She's on a tripod. I'm going to take the tripod and also the little clamp. You can clamp at the end of the table. I really don't know what to expect at the state board because it's been so long. So here is she. I have her prepped for the eyelash application. So basically you have to take your mannequin in there already prepped with an eyelash on there to represent her natural lash line. Okay, so let's get started. This is the first bag right here. Okay, so let's get started. This is the first bag. This is my pre-examination universal sanitation supplies right here. And I put it in a big Ziploc bag here. So I'm gonna show you what's all in this bag. We have paper towels. We have my EPA disinfectant. Everything that has to be labeled, the PSI package will let you know. So this is labeled. I have my Germex. This doesn't have to be labeled, it already has a label. I have my blood exposure kit. This one right here, it's like the real blood exposure, just in case I cut myself in the exam room. Of course, I can't cut my mannequin. Then I have a spray bottle with water and it's labeled. And then I have the clamp for the edge of the table, just in case I need it. Like I said, I'm taking my tripod and this one right here. Now I'm gonna show you what's in my blood exposure kit. So in the blood exposure kit, I have some Band-Aids. I have a pair of gloves. I have some gauze. I'm gonna put some alcohol on these. And then I have my bio bag. Okay, so I'm just gonna put everything back in here. That is my first bag. This is my second bag. This is the monomer and polymer over tip. It's right here. I'm gonna pronounce some things wrong or say words funny. Do that all the time. So first thing we have our towels. I have two towels. I got my finger. I have my primer. My primer. I got it. This one I did get from the supply store. This is my monomer and polymer. This is odorless. It has to be odorless for the state board. I have my tips in a little container. And I did measure them to the finger just so I won't have to like waste time trying to find a good tip size. I have the glue right here. This is my favorite glue. I use this on my clients. I have my dapping dish right here. I have some nail clippers, tip clippers. I usually don't use tip clippers. I like to use like the little scissors and a nail form to measure it. Then we have my acrylic application brush right here. I have a cuticle pusher and a nail brush. And then I have all of my disposables in this bag. Let's get started. So I have my wooden sticks right here. Orange wood sticks to push the cuticle back. I'm not sure why they have both on there, like the regular cuticle pusher and the wood stick. Then I have a little bag for trash. I have a regular nail file. I have some buffers. I did pack some extra nail files. These are really little and small. Of course, I packed some cotton balls and some paper towels. Of course, I'm going to use this for when I am applying the acrylic. And then I have some extra cotton pads just to have them there just in case I need them. Okay, so now I'm just gonna put everything away. Okay, so I am going in order. So the next bag, it's the blood exposure incident service. So you're gonna have a kit, a real like blood exposure kit. Then you have the one that you're gonna provide for this service, like the service to show them that you know how to do it. So let me take everything out. So I have some band-aids and some gauze. Like I'm gonna put some alcohol on these gauze. Then I have the gloves. I have my bio bag. I have some napkins just to place everything on top. And then I have a trash bag and it's labeled trash. For blood exposure, any bio bags, you do have to double bag. So I'm gonna show you the little setup. Okay, so now I'm gonna put everything back in the bag. Okay, so that's all for this second bag or second service. Next bag is the eyelash strip application service right here. Okay, so I'm gonna take everything out, show you. So for the draping, I'm gonna use a towel and I'm gonna wrap it around her neck and clip it with this clip. And then I'm gonna show you everything that's in this little bag. So I have the eyelashes I'm gonna use. I am gonna get a container for these. They do have to come in a closed container. Then I have my lash glue. Then I have my little spatula. This is to put the glue, eyelash glue on. And then from the, like the spatula, I can put it on the lash strip. I have a plastic cap. I have some gloves, have some little scissors and tweezers. These are to measure the strip, make sure it fits her eye. And these are to actually apply the strip. And some napkins just to place, spread them out and place all the stuff on there. Okay, I'm gonna show you this setup. Okay, so this is the setup for the lash application service. And it's just the strip. Okay. So this is the third service. I mean second service or third. Okay, so next one is the facial service right here. This is the bag labeled. Okay, so first thing we have the towels, two towels. We have a makeup cape. Really small cape. Then I have the cleansing cream. So all of these are mock, they're not the actual product. I just grabbed anything that was random in my restroom and put them in these little containers. And I'm telling you, everything that I'm showing you, I got it off of Amazon. The containers, everything. The moisturizer. Have the massage cream. I have a makeup removal and a toner. Spray toner. And of course, I have this clip to clip the towels to the neck. And then we have all the disposable stuff. Disposable stuff doesn't have to be labeled. So we have a bunch of spatulas and wooden sticks. And these are just to scoop the stuff out of the containers. We have the plastic cap. We have a headband right here. We have the little cotton circles. And then we have just paper towels just to set everything on top. Okay, I'm gonna show you the setup. Put everything on. Okay, so this is the facial bag. Okay, next bag is the haircut service. And all of my bags are labeled. I just put haircut service, pre-sanitized implements. I literally put pre-sanitized implements after every service name. Just to make sure to let them know that everything's sanitized. Let me show you what's in this bag. Let's see. So, I have four clips. And these are just to separate the hair into four quadrants. And I'm not even sure, I need to practice my haircut because I haven't done a haircut in like 7 years since I graduated. So I need to practice that. I have two combs and two rat tail. I have my cape right here. And these clips, I got them from the Sally's, a beauty supply store. I have in here just a napkin to put all of my stuff on, like the combs and the shears and stuff, lay them on top. Then I have some neck strips so it won't touch the cape. Then I just have some extra little towels. Then in there I have my shears and my razor wrapped in there. So anything I didn't get off of Amazon, I will like let you know, like the clips or the primer. Yeah, my eyelash glue, of course, I just got it from the beauty supply store as well. Let me show you the setup. Just gonna put it away now.
Okay.
The next bag is the waxing using soft wax service mock. Okay, let me take everything out of this bag. So, once again, I have the towels. I'm gonna do that same draping thing where I just use the towel, wrap it around her neck, and clip it with this clip. Then I have my fake soft wax. I put mock wax. I just use Vaseline. Then I have all of my disposables. I have two pairs of gloves. I have a headband, little sticks, wooden sticks, a plastic cape, a napkin to set everything on top. And then I have my strips for the waxing right here. So let me show you this setup. Okay, now I'm gonna just put everything away. This is the soft wax service. Okay, next bag is the permanent wing service. Okay, let me take it out. Everything out. So I have the mock waving solution, and I did label it like that. I still have to put some solution in there. I'm probably just gonna put water in there. So I have my rods here. I think you just have to do four, but I did pack extra just in case any of them fall. What's this? I have my four clips I got from the supply store, Sally's. I got two rat tail combs. I have my two towels. So this is a chemical draping, so I'm gonna have to do towel, chemical drape, and then towel. And this is just to clip the towels. Then I have some gloves. I have my end papers right here. They're all freaking squished in here. I don't know. That happens maybe because I keep moving all these bags around. Here's the end papers. I got some napkins in there just in case, and I can set some stuff on top. And then I did use some Vaseline, and I labeled it protective cream base or right here. This container, I did get it off of Amazon. Well, everything I got off of Amazon, the only thing I didn't was the clips and the rat tail combs. Got it from that supply store. Let me show you this right here. Ah! Let me show you the setup. These end papers literally fly everywhere. Okay. So this is the setup for the permanent waving mock. All of these. And now let me just put it away. Okay, this is the permanent waving bag. Okay, next one is the blow dry and thermal curling. Yeah, I sometimes I don't say some words right. Oh, it has to do with me knowing two languages, Spanish and English, hopefully. Hopefully it's that. So let's get started. I'm gonna show you what's in this bag. Okay, so I got a round brush. Then I have my blow dryer, got off Amazon. Then I have my curling iron right here. Okay, I got my clips to section off the hair. I have some napkins and some neck strips. I'm gonna use the neck strips to test the temperature of my curling iron. I have some combs and rat tail combs. And then I have some towels right here. This is a really big bag. I didn't even know these existed. They're freaking huge. Let me show you this setup. Okay, now I'm gonna put it away. So this is the blow dry and thermal curling bag. And now we have the last service, which is the chemical application mock service. All of this in here. Let me take everything out. Okay, so I have a bowl. I got some combs and rat tail combs. I have multiple application brushes. Chemical application brushes. Just in case one falls. I got my clips. I got my three mock chemicals. One is foil highlights. I did get some random stuff from my restroom again, and I just put hair dye, or not hair dye, food coloring in them. They look pretty cool. This one didn't really mix, but this one, these did, and they look really cool. Hydroxide relaxer retouch. This is for retouch. And this one is for the hydroxide virgin relaxer. This looks so cool. The color, I love it. Then I got some foils, some napkins, a spatula, and here's the gloves, protective base cream, spatula, some napkins, and the foils. Then we got some towels. I think I'm gonna order another chemical drape for this set. Like I said, I don't really know what to expect or if I can keep using the same draping from other drapes, like other services. I think I heard that you can, as long as they're not soiled or nothing got onto them. So, but I'm just gonna order another one just to be safe, you know? Okay, so let me show you this setup. Okay, this is the setup. Okay, so I'm just gonna put everything away. Thank you. Okay, so this is the last service. Okay, so that completes my video. That is how I pack my Cosmetology State Board practical kit. If this helped any of y'all, I hope it does help some people out there that are about to go take their practical. If you like the video, like and subscribe so you can keep watching more of my content. Bye guys, see you in the next video.